Most people go through their whole lives blind to the things around them. I don't mean the usual stuff like violence, love, stoplights. I mean the little things, like the sound a woman makes when she's thinking, the smell of fear, the little mannerisms that give them away when someone's lying. Most people just aren't aware, but I am. My name is Kurt, but everybody calls me Dirt, Dirt Merchant, and I'm a private eye who just cracked his first big case. Well, hang on. I'm getting ahead of myself. You see, I wasn't always a private eye. I had an entry-level job at Atomic Frog Records, where I spent my days running errands, delivering mail, and picking up dry cleaning. Basically every menial and degrading job they could think of. I was just paying my dues. All in a futile attempt to impress the all-powerful and influential Ronnie Orlando.
I don't want to talk business. I want to go business.
You're a good boy. When you get home, I'll give you a nice cold ice cube.
Can I have your own
bath? Why the fuck?
Dusty, groovy, leeches.
Oh, that's it. Don't stop. Keep trying. Come on. Get away from me! What are you doing, you crazy bitch? Jesus! Sorry, man. We were just talking and, she tripped and her head fell in my crotch area. Hey, Johnny. Good to see you, man.
Huh? Who are you?
That's Ronnie, Johnny. Sorry, he hasn't had his Thorazine yet.
So you wanted to talk about what?
My career.
Your what? Oh, what, you mean your latest, X-rated thing. What was that called, Oh, yeah, On My Knees to Please. Yeah, real classic. I just love the way you come, Holly, your trademark.
Not my movie career, you idiot. My recording career.
Didn't know you had one.
Well, I'm going to. Isn't that right, Johnny? Johnny!
Huh? Oh, hey, Ronnie.
Hey, Johnny.
What's up, man?
We were talking about my recording contract. Johnny and I have decided that if you want to re-sign him, you have to sign me first. Isn't that right, Johnny?
Whatever, babe.
So, I wrote down a few figures.
3-record deal, $1 million advance, no negotiations. Come on, Holly, please. Maybe a demo deal, maybe. But this is freaking ridiculous.
Ridiculous, is it? Clive Fagan, please. Yes, it's Holly So Tightly and Johnny Decay calling. We were just wondering whether Urethra Records was still interested in signing...
All right, you win! We'll fucking sign you! First, we gotta re-sign him.
Well, you just leave that to me. Partner.
Ah! Of course, our main cash cow continues to be the phenomenal Johnny Decay. However, I am looking to the future and have already signed 3 exciting new alternative acts whom I believe can win the hearts and the minds and the pocketbooks of today's disaffected youth audience. I am talking about Beaver Probe, Barf Bag, and Trouser Bulge.
Excuse me, this lad here, an actual living demographic of the Generation X. Come in, son. Tell me, what is your name?
Dirt, sir.
Dirt. What do you think about these new bands?
Honestly? Nothing but a bunch of loser butt rock posers. I mean, even Johnny Decay, you know? He was hit back when he was a no-bullshit Chapel Hill garage act. But success led to excess, fame made him lame, and credibility went straight out his ass.
So, what would your strategy be?
I think we've heard enough, Dirt.
No, just hear me out here, Ronnie. Obscurity equals purity, which means focus on no-name bands with real talent and street credentials. Hey, you guys make me a creative director. I'd be glad.
Dirt, may I have a word with you for a minute?
Sure, Ronnie.
Yeah,
where are we going?
Yeah, I got a surprise for you. 1, 3, you got it, punk! You embarrassed me in front of my investors! You are finished in this town! You are never gonna work again in this business, so help me fucking God!
Yep, that was the end of my music career. So, I started drinking heavily for about 6 months. That's my buddy Sponge. We grew up across the street from each other, and he moved out here with me a year ago when I left college.
You guys smoke some of these bud rides here, man. God.
That's my other roommate, Zeke. Zeke the Geek. As you can see, he's not much of a ladies' man. While my other roommate, Sly, takes him on two at a time. Asshole. And then there's me. A guy without a job is a sad sight. Ego beaten down, hopeless beyond belief. The stench of failure emanating from me like a rotten fish. My girlfriend, Angie, caught a whiff and dumped me. Man, my life basically sucked. I came to Los Angeles to open my own record company. I was gonna rock the music establishment by the age of 25. You see, back in college, I was dirt merchant. The merchant man. I mean, I booked concerts, managed the radio station, DJed. That was the night I hit rock bottom. I knew I had to get my shit together, so I scraped my sorry ass off the floor and decided to get a job. Any job.
All right, let's see what we have here. University of Michigan. Hey, how about those Wolverines?
Go blue.
Sound engineering major. Never graduated.
I had a job offer.
Oh, yes, I see. Mailroom boy? Atomic Frog Records. What happened?
Creative differences.
Fired, huh? Too bad. And without a college degree.
I need a college degree for this shitty job.
You getting smart with me, Curtis?
No, sir. Sorry.
Another question. Did you ever use drugs?
No, sir.
That's good. Because our strict zero tolerance policy does require mandatory testing. And for my days as an MP, I'd say those pupils look a wee bit dilated.
Yeah, I was up pretty late last night.
Now drinking with the guys?
Just a few beers, officer.
What about these earrings?
Ow, yeah. What about them?
You one of those backdoor kind of guys? Huh?
No, sir. Front door man all the way. When I get the chance, which hasn't been too often lately.
Oh, no wife, not even a girlfriend.
Well, I went back in school, but...
She dumped you. I'll show you around. Come on, son. Gotta warn you though, the job's only for 3 months. Then we bring in the robots.
Robots?
Yeah, from Korea. We're going fully automated. We're darn proud of it.
So will they replace you too?
Excuse me?
With the robots. I mean, I figure they'll replace the rest of us. So... Jesus, just kidding.
What did you just say?
What? Christ.
You just took the Lord's name in vain, buddy!
Interview after interview, I got turned down like a leper at a swingers party. Sponge told me about this guy who drives around and buys blood from people in a converted ice cream truck. Hey, it's not glamorous, but it's honest.
Hey, I donate every morning just to, jumpstart my day.
Quart a day keeps the doc away, huh? Give me your arm. There you go. Help a young boy like you? Come on, look at you. Oh, yeah. You're a walking gold mine. Oh, yeah. That's nice. That's real nice.
Ow!
Stay still.
Ow!
Ow!
Still.
fill her up with extra. Red gold. Transylvania tea.
Okay. Just say when. More?
Was that more? Oh, sure, yeah. Just top it off here.
$20 is yours. My blood.
It was getting to the point that I didn't even have enough gas money to get to the interviews. Man, I was really getting desperate.
How's your sperm doing?
It's fine.
$5 a squirt.
Not that desperate.
All right, who's next, Mary?
Damn it, Sly. Dude, where's the coffee and day-old bagels you're supposed to swipe from work, huh? I mean, how are we supposed to survive if we all don't chip in and steal our part? What is that sweet, funky odor?
My poor blue-balled friend. Has it really been that long?
Wait a second. Don't tell me. You got laid again?
Am I on a roll or what?
I can't believe this. I haven't gotten laid in a year, and you... I mean, look at you.
What about me?
Cheers, big ears.
Same goes, big nose.
Oh, looks like the landlord. She finds us here. Look, you handle it.
Dirt? Hello?
I knew that voice. It wasn't my landlord, it was Angie, the girl who dumped me. Man, she looked great, and I hadn't showered in days. Perfect time for her to walk back into my life.
You haven't changed a bit.
Yeah, well, you sure have. I mean, look at you. Gucci pumps, power suit, manicure, wax legs, makeup. Put it all together and I come up with...
What?
How you finally graduated. Spent the summer at Grosse Pointe getting socially indoctrinated by your mom. Then you decided to move to LA. Where daddy got you some spiffy new office job, set you up with your own condo, full set of credit cards, and what? Shiny new Beamer?
You know, Dirt, you always were amazingly observant. About other people, anyway.
And since our phone's unlisted, that means you had to call my parents to get our address. Which means you wanted to see me. Which means, Angie, you still love me.
Get over it, loser.
Trust me, I am totally over it.
Yeah, well, so am I.
Why are you the one who finally came crawling back?
Crawling back? Hardly.
Then what are you doing here?
Maybe I just wanted to see how your hot LA music career was going.
Ouch. Definitely below the belt.
Oh no, Sly McFly. Slyer the liar.
Angie the X. Back for some sex?
Oh, in his dreams.
Nice shoulder pads, Ange. Playing full contact today?
Yo, Sponge, shake and bake! You gotta check this out!
Oh my god, what's he doing?
Working for this dream deprivation study at UCLA Med School. Kid actually gets paid to get stoned out of his mind all night and hibernate all day.
One job he's definitely qualified for.
Oh, baby. Oh, right. Oh, Chelsea, baby, you are so, so naughty. Oh, yeah. Go ahead, right there. Hello, Mr. President. Mrs. President.
Angie?
Oh, shit, Angie! Is that really you?
Yes, Sponge, it's really me.
But you're like different. And what's that weird perfume?
Oh, it's called Soap, Sponge. You gotta try it sometime.
Ah, no way, babe. Check me out, huh? Grunge lives.
Or something died. God, I don't believe this. You guys,
still together.
Ah. See, Spoogies!
Partners in slime!
He washes my back while I hit the rack.
He's dirt.
I'm sponge.
I make the mess.
And I clean up, baby.
Hunter, what are you doing with your life anyway?
Hey, I'm doing fine, thank you.
You call this fine? Dirt, you obviously don't have a job or a girlfriend or even a clue.
Hey, I've got plenty of clues, okay? And as for girlfriends, I've decided to be celibate.
Really?
Of course, I'm also environmentally conscious, which means I'll recycle any old girlfriend I can find. Ow, shit!
Look, would you get serious?
I was serious.
Look at yourself. You are such a smart guy with so much potential, reduced to living in some urban slum with a walking dickhead and a no-hope or doper for whom the big picture of life holds 4 pints.
And just leave my friends out of this, okay?
Fine. Now I'll just criticize you.
Oh, great. What qualifies you to be Little Miss Guidance Counselor, huh? Just because Daddy can snap his fingers and get you any old job you want?
Excuse me, but I got this job all by myself.
You work at Atomic Frog Records? Assistant creative director? Shit, that was my job. The job I wanted.
And you probably would have gotten it if you hadn't been so damn full of yourself.
Full of myself? They asked me for my opinion and I gave it.
Yes, if you're such a genius, you don't need my advice.
That's right.
So?
Look, this was obviously a bad idea and I have to get back for a meeting. You have my card, maybe we could do lunch sometime.
Sure, that'd be great. You know, thanks for coming by. It was really nice seeing you. And congratulations on your new job.
You really mean it?
Sure. Happy for you, Ange.
Thanks. Call me, okay? Let's be friends.
Absolutely. Finally starting to get over her.
Don't give the bitch the satisfaction, okay? Anyway, like you said, she's totally changed.
Yeah, bro. From a Betty into like a total Veronica.
Yeah, from a Marianne to a total Ginger.
From a I Dream of Jeannie into a total Major Healy.
Poetry girl. Dark side psychopathic type, complexly enigmatic, yet potentially primordial and sad.
You want to stay in here, my poetry slam?
No, just give me some gas money. I'm not sure why, but I was feeling optimistic, like my luck was about to change. I guess I figured that when you're down, there's nowhere left to go but up. All right. I guess there was still room to go down.
What else, huh?
Hey! I remember you!
And that's when I saw it. Excuse me. I saw the sign outside. I was wondering if you're still hiring.
Do you have a resume?
No, but I have me.
Jake, there's somebody here about the job.
Send the poor, desperate bastard in.
Thanks.
How is she? Do you know what a private process server is?
Yeah, summon servers, subpoenas and stuff. A buddy of mine used to do it back in Detroit.
Then maybe he taught you the golden rule. Defendant touches paper. He serves.
So when do I start?
Not so fast. You got a car?
If you want to call it that.
No computers?
Well, I can download free porn off the internet.
Have to teach me that sometime. Any criminal record?
Straight out of Compton by NWA. Other than that, nothing major.
Wise ass.
Sorry.
But I gotta warn you, kid. This job is brutal. You gotta stare danger in the eye every day. Gotta con poor mothers into giving up their psychotic sons. Gotta talk desperate young women into giving up their... Well, you get the general idea.
Cool. But just one more question, kid. Are you aware?
Aware of what?
Detail, nuances, slight manifestations of abnormal reality. In other words, do you notice shit?
You mean like the fact that there was nothing in that file you were reading but a racing form? Or your wedding ring tan line? Or the cop bad eye you're giving me right now? But since there's no honorable discharge on the wall from the PD, maybe you don't like to talk about why you left the force.
Anything else, wise ass?
Yeah, that all of a sudden, you really don't like me.
Sure, I like you, Dirk. You want a job? We got one.
Cool. Who's this?
El Niño del Diablo Sanchez. The greatest Mexican wrestler of his generation. But after Hernando Hercules off the rope flying groin stomp in 89, he was never the same. His old lady's suing him for marital neglect. But the problem is, we don't even know what he looks like.
He never takes his mask off?
Not even during sex.
How would you know?
Anyway, he's gone underground. My boys haven't been able to serve paper on him all year. You're a smart kid, right, Dirk?
When I have to be.
Go get him. Serve El Nino his summons. And you can pick up 40 bucks cash.
40 bucks? All right.
And not that it's any of your business. I didn't have to leave the force. I quit. Got that?
Sure, Jake. Do you want to talk about that?
Get the fuck out of my face.
I thought that went pretty well. Okay. So all I gotta do is find one guy.
Wrestling.
Piece of cake.
Wait a second. Pizza. You like pizza, dude?
Hola, this is El Niño Sanchez, and I want to order the usual.
Hey, El Niño! Hey, long time, ese! Okay, so one mucho grande, meatball and anchovies.
Si, amigo.
Okay, ese.
So, you remember where I live? Mi adreso? Bueno, yeah.
So the address led me to the seedy gym on the outskirts of East L.A.
Delivery from Cheesy Pizza.
I didn't order no freaking pizza.
That may be true, senor, but on account of the salmonella poisoning from last week, we're treating all our regular customers to a free pizza.
What kind is it?
Meatball with extra anchovies.
Take those 20s crisp and folded.
How'd you like your butt crisp and folded?
You know, Jake, you really could lose the hostility.
Sure, smartass. But first, let's just make sure that wasn't beginner's luck. Okay, Sergeant Andrew Sampson owes damages from a hunting accident. Can't serve him on the base, so check out his credit card records.
Bunch of bar tabs at a place called the Arsenal. Subscription to guns and ammo. Muffler, shocks, new Glock 9mm at Central Gun Exchange, and 4,000 rounds of ammo.
Good luck, Dirt.
I began developing my own strategy on finding these people. People are basically predictable and creatures of habit. All I had to do is find out what they do and where they do it, and that would lead me to them. It was a dangerous job. But it was exciting and stimulating. And it beat waiting tables. cool thing is that nobody ever thinks that I'm a summon server. You gotta play on their sympathy, or patronage, or whatever angle you can find. And then you gotta be ready to jam. People always want to kill the messenger.
$200 less state and federal tax, FICA, unemployment insurance, detective union dues, leaving you with a grand total of, $87.02.
Thanks. Just enough for this week's parking tickets.
Now that I was back on my feet, it was time to see Angie.
Gotta talk poor mothers into giving up their psycho sons. Gotta talk desperate young women into giving up their... You get the idea.
God, it sounds so dangerous. Don't you ever get scared?
Just gotta be suave and very aware.
Oh, what are you aware of now, Mr. Suave?
Head slice scamming on that cyber chick over there.
What else is new?
That you're actually smiling at me the same way you used to. Which means it's all coming back to you.
What is?
Just how perfect we were together.
Oh, really?
And since I've got a line on 2 morphine tickets tonight, what do you say we drain these javas, head back to my shack d'amour, and start making up for lost time?
Well, first of all, I'm already going to morphine tonight. Backstage pass. Secondly, I have plans with Ronnie.
You're going out with Ronnie Orlando?
Dirt, it's my job.
What, dating your boss?
Yeah, you are so transparently jealous.
What, just because I like to rip off his greasy nuts?
Look, Dirt. I care about you. Really, I do, but...
What?
Don't you see? I mean, we're just so different now, and I thought you understood that I just want to be friends.
Friends.
Excuse me. Hello? Oh, hi, Ronnie. No, just having coffee with an old friend.
Old friend?
Oh, yeah. Oh,
bitch.
I was just leaving. I'm sorry, but we're on the verge of closing a very juicy deal right now, and...
Yeah, you mean he is.
Goodbye, Darren. Good luck.
Not even worth it.
This is a 405 Mangler update, where the 405 Mangler's latest victim was found.
Yo, is that the same as the 205 Tingler? Now, the
body was found by he's in jail. You're thinking of the 210 torture.
Oh, the one Dirt wrote the screenplay about.
No, that was the 705 Slayer.
Oh, hard to keep up on your serial killers these days, huh?
And you know what? They're all connected.
Right. I am with the band. Didn't you see the last set? We totally rocked. Yeah, baby. I think that's gonna work.
This is my worst nightmare. Angie and Ronnie Orlando. The girl who broke my heart and the total asshole who ruined my entire career. Of course, she'd never sleep with that scumbag, but...
Oh, no? Now, how the hell do you think she got the job in the first place, man?
Now, tell me about some of your other office assets.
Well, I can fax, and I'm really good on the phone.
Do you give dictation? Oh, yeah.
Oh, you are so high. Bastard! That slut! I've got to get her back.
In the Hollywood.
Look, there's Breck and Fly and that stone booty plugger.
Yeah, be cool, baby. Hey, Lonnie.
Here's my fucking royalty check.
Hey, in the mail. Hey, listen, I want you to meet Angie, my new creative director.
I have all your albums, and I am so looking forward to doing business with you.
Doing business is my specialty, low-low tech.
Hey, hey, Nikki, baby. Hey, 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 it's business, babe. I'll be back in a second.
Hi, first of all, where's Johnny?
Oh, he's in detox, but he said to say that he loves everyone and to go buy his new album.
And whose outfit is that you're wearing?
It's mine from third grade. Sister Chester, school for girls.
Very retro. And how does it feel to be called the biggest star fucker in the business?
Super Dowgers, Doctors, and Deceivers. I'm with the DJs.
That thing off.
Turn up, we'll see.
Good, give me a fucking martini.
Dead film star. K Cash is Jack. A hand that blew for first ocean, now from Jack.
I'm with her.
You or me. To the broken rails.
I watched her from a distance as the music pulsated and people schmoozed and mingled. I tried to blend with the Eurotrash, the silicone bitches, and the music agents and industry wannabes. It was all I could do not to throw up from the spectacle. She seemed out of place as she sat in the corner alone. I wanted to go over and talk, have a few laughs like the old days, tell her how I felt about her, how phony everybody was. But mostly I wanted to keep Ronnie away from her. In the meantime, I sampled some of the local drinks, kind of hoping I didn't catch a roofie in the process from one of these desperate guys trying to get laid.
Ronnie, I'm so frustrated.
Oh, babe.
I've met all these huge names in the business tonight, and it's like not one of them takes me seriously.
Hey, babe, I do, huh? Just, you gotta get the time, you know? Pay dues, do what needs to get done to get ahead, because it's a tough business.
Okay.
Hey, but when the gong gets fucked up, you gotta fucking get going, huh? All right, come on. Yeah, now look, drink this. It'll really get you going.
What a bunch of wannabes, huh?
What are you doing here? Merch at the homeless charity ain't till next week.
Listen up here, Ronnie Orlando. Since I left your sorry-ass company, I happen to be happening in a very major way. You're making some serious cash in the process.
Well, I see, Mr. Happening. Well, then, by all means, sit your major ass down. Swizzle some of my cristal. Keep your old friend company.
Are you drunk?
Yeah, just fervent and swerving.
God, this is so embarrassing. What are you doing here anyway?
That's a question, right there!
Huh?
Right there!
Whoa, whoa, hey!
All right, Sherlock. How'd you like to make some real Gitas?
What's the op, Pop? Thunderbolt 5-2 in the third to win.
That's the wrong file. Here you go. You used to work at the Atomic Frog, right? Now somebody's trying to sue your old boss, Ronnie Orlando, and that junkie rock star.
Johnny Decay?
The client's name is... What the hell is the guy's name? Jeffrey Allen Spacey.
Complaint for monetary damages. $10 million. As the true writer of defendant's recordings, abuse me, I suck, and Jesus, all of Johnny's greatest hits. How much for both?
2 C's for Orlando and a cool G for Decay.
All right, I know where to find Ronnie. Where the hell is Johnny?
That's your problem, Seamus.
Yo, what's up? I got like a special delivery for Ronnie Orlando.
Where have I seen you before?
Oh, probably on like TV or some shit. See, I used to be like a backup breakdancer for like New Kids on the Block. You remember me? I was like, and I'd be like, whoa, what's up? Whoa, come on, baby. Whoa, hit me now.
corner office. Just go.
Yo.
Revenge is a dish best served in person. I couldn't wait to see the look on Ronnie's face when I handed him that subpoena.
I need your money to help me sign two exciting new alternative bands whom I believe have the potential to hit the charts with a bullet. I am talking about Sludge Swimmers and the new British sensation, Wanker Wart.
Dirt?
Save your money, guys, because those bands suck.
Would you just get out?
Hold on one second, Miss Meredith. There's just one more thing I need to say. That is, if Ronnie here had just listened to me a year ago instead of tanking my ass for being honest,
that's it, you're dead!
Eat dirt. Biatch!
Son of a bitch!
Now it's really over, Dirt. I don't love you, I don't like you, we're not even friends. Hi.
So she was a little upset, but it was so worth it to nail Ronnie in front of his investors. Anyway, what did I think she was gonna do? Get up and say, "Oh, Dirt, you're my hero. You saved me from Ronnie, the bad, bad man." Then quit her job and be my girl Friday? Hang out on stakeouts? Yeah, right. But right now, I have other things on my mind. Johnny Decay. I hope he doesn't have a dog.
Mr. Decay? I have a summons here for you from Mr. Spacey. He's suing you for the, Johnny? Johnny?
Holy shit!
Hi, 911? Yeah, I'm at, I'm at 1914 Hollyview Drive in LA. And, there's a guy here and he's dead. No, I mean, he's really dead. He's dead, he's definitely dead. And, what? Why do you need my name?
Shoot.
What? No, don't worry. This is my gun.
Who are you?
I was just...
Where's Johnny?
No, I swear, he was dead when I got here.
What? You.
See, it's not what you think. I was just here and then...
Bitch!
Ow!
Who are you?
Detective Harry Ball, homicide. So, now that you've had a refreshing dip, perhaps you'd like to humor us with the dirty details of your big day here.
I was just delivering a...
The heroin that killed Decay?
What? No. I was serving him a summons and I found him on the...
Liar! I caught him red-handed. He killed Johnny, just like I told you.
What are you talking about? Yo, dude, it's totally obvious.
Obvious my ass, punk. You Belushi Decay, so now you're going down.
What?
So, you like smack, huh, merchant?
Ow! I didn't do anything.
Is that so?
You cops, we have to rush the judgment. Did you ever consider the alternative here?
What alternative?
Well, first of all, did anybody find any heroin?
What's this look like, smart guy?
Coke. Huh? Coke. Go on, taste it. Then let's consider the rest of the evidence. Oh, look. Here's the summons I was here to serve.
What?
No track marks on his arm, which makes sense because he just got out of detox.
What the hell does that prove?
Nothing in itself, but... There you go, smell him. See, that's shampoo, which means he recently showered. But junkies hate to bathe, because the dirt clogs their pores, maintains their high.
Shut up, Quincy. I still got a case here.
Oh, really? Well, then where's the hose he used to tie off his arm before he shot up, huh? And where's his works?
You know a lot about drugs, don't you, punk? Look at this. Fresh needle marks.
I give blood.
Yeah? You better start telling the truth or you're going to give a whole lot more.
What happened?
Look.
No, no, Johnny!
No!
What happened? Who did this?
He did.
No. No. Didn't do it.
Take this common piece of shit down and book him before some other girl comes along and beats the ugly out of him.
Oh.
That's all right, sweetheart. It's going to be okay. Oh, don't worry about a thing. It's going to be fine.
Out of my way, I'm gonna smash your face.
Yeah, they call the cold turkey. Worst band these ears I've ever heard.
Well, kids like it? Yeah, absolutely. Let's sign it.
Ronnie, I have terrible news. I just heard on K-Rock, Johnny, he's dead. Dead.
Oh my God, this is terrible. I'm shocked. I'm devastated. Thank God we had insurance. Yeah.
All right, Merchant. Your boss, Jake Brodsky, just vouched for you. And he and I go back a long way. So I guess you're a free man for now. Get up. Just don't even think about leaving town. And you better pray to God I don't find any evidence.
Evidence? What evidence? Thanks a lot, Jake. Definitely owe you one.
Hey, look, kid, I know you're no killer. And I gotta admit, you're a hell of an operative, even if you do drive me to drink. But you're a hot potato, and I gotta let you go.
I'm fired?
Sorry, kid.
Forget it, Jake. It's Chinatown.
Detective Harry Ball?
Who the hell's this?
Oh, just call me Deep Throat.
You expect me to swallow that?
I just wanted you to know Johnny Decay was murdered. And you had the right man. But you just let him walk.
What? Hello? Hey, you.
Great-great-grandfather, he brought hemp to this country in the Mayflower. It's the answer to all our problems. We're not talking clothes, fuel, rope, building materials, baby formula, hair weave, slide. Try with this.
Why?
What is it? Experimental truth serum developed from various controlled substances spun ripped off from the bed.
Look at that fat-ass butt. Look at all the red hairs.
Pesticides kill only 8 out of 10 insects.
Oh, you want to know something really scary?
Psych alert. Goodbye.
Or maybe I'm the only one who's sane around here. Here.
Motherfucker.
Hello? Guys, hey!
Stop the party!
Why, dude?
Why everybody freeze?
That's why.
They found me. It's begun.
Stop, I said nobody move!
Merchant, where's your room?
Back corner.
Chet, check it out.
What the hell's going on here?
You're really gonna fry, Merchant.
For what?
Murdering Johnny DeKay. One screenplay. I was a teenage serial killer.
The hell does that prove?
Yeah, what are you gonna do? Bust them for bad plot structure?
One CD Black Sabbath. What are you, a Satan worshiper? One stack of photos of the victim, all defaced.
Those aren't mine.
What do we got here? One murder weapon.
Look, I swear to God, I have never seen that thing before in my entire life.
You have the right to shut up. Anything you say can and will piss me off. If you can't afford a shyster attorney, we will assign you an overworked loser who doesn't give a shit and will screw up your case anyway. Now, do you understand your rights?
Yeah, I understand. This is a total frame-up. Speaking of rights, where's your warrant anyway?
Warrant? Shit!
Helter! Stop him!
I ran some more. My mind was racing. Who the hell was the bald guy with the gun? Why had somebody planted that stuff in my room? All I knew is that I had to get away. I just kept running until I was sure no one was following me. Man, I just needed to get my head together. Okay, someone was trying to frame me. Who really killed Johnny and why? I was tired and not thinking clearly, so I found a place to crash for the night.
Just get in the car.
That is the last time I listen to you. Some exclusive. We show up at the house and there's already 1,000 stalkerazzi there before us. Just get me out of here. I gotta get my nails done.
Right.
Oh shit, wait, there he is. Hi, hello, Roxy Rose from XTV. Got some dirt you wanna dish on your roommate?
Whoa, scram you TV tabloid trash.
Yeah, no way we're ratting out our bro.
Bro, our lawn is full of reporters. Let's bail.
Come on, guys. You can be the next Kato. Be famous. Write a book. Hang out with Charlie Sheen.
Charlie Sheen?
Mm-hmm.
How much?
Oh, I'm sorry. We don't pay for our
interview. Too bad. No loot, no shoot.
Okay, wait. $100.
A piece.
Okay, deal. There you go. Now, tell the world what you know about Dirt Merchant.
Well, he's definitely our bro, you know? I mean, we hang out. And most of the time, he's like mad cool. But lately, he's been a little whack.
Hey, come to think about it, he's got a real dark side.
Dirt Merchant, the dark side.
Unbelievable.
What is?
You've humped half my record collection.
Yeah, and sometimes he just starts yelling about wanting to go out and just kill someone.
Really? Kill who?
Holy shit.
Who is it?
Like anyone.
It's my goddamn roommates.
Well, other than that, they're just your normal, everyday, average, sociopathic young American. No different from you or me.
Consider yourself lucky. At least you still have friends. My last three guys, Eric, Bart, Johnny, dead, gone. I mean, do I have bad karma or what?
Maybe. You know, but, well, sometimes shit just happens.
You are so understanding.
Thanks.
Kiss me, you tool.
What are you doing?
Centering myself. Join me.
Okay.
Just relax and breathe deep. Find that space of total peace and spiritual tranquility. Now do me dirty, sir.
Holly went on to explain Spacey's obsession with Johnny. How Spacey had a nervous breakdown and Orlando got rid of him. How Johnny was just a pretty boy poser. And how Spacey was the real talent behind the band. Then Johnny got into drugs to hide from the truth. Because he couldn't handle the fact that the fans didn't really love him. They loved Spacey's music.
We better find you a disguise. You can't go out looking like you. They took all of Johnny's stuff, but they left this. It might fit you.
What, are you kidding me?
It's either this or Catwoman.
Oh! What the
shit, man?
Yo, Sly, check it out. Forrest Gump. It's a disguise, Bong for Brains.
Seriously, bro, we've been worried about you.
And now we're, like, really worried.
Yeah, I saw how worried you guys were on TV. Made me sound like the 405 Mango.
Beg it.
No phone record or credit cards. Doesn't even get junk mail.
This Spacey guy is definitely sly.
Guys, we've got to find his address, okay? Could be the key to solving this entire case.
Bro, you ever just think about bailing?
Yeah, man. Just hop in the saddle, say hasta luego. Hightail it down to old Mexico. Beers are cheaper and the hookers don't wear beepers.
Bring me the head of Dirt Merchant.
Hey, I am not running away from this, okay? I'm staying right here, defending my good name.
Dirt Merchant's a good name?
Look, I wouldn't do this for anyone else, Dirt. But maybe the feds have a file on Spacey.
Gotcha.
Jeffrey Allen Spacey, 666 Darkwoods Lane, Lost Hills. And check out his record. Felony animal abuse, illegal dumping, urinating in public. Classic profile.
Sounds like my kind of guy, man.
Yeah, a total maniac.
Don't worry. I've got what you need.
Do you remember the Boy Scout marching code?
What? Run if the Scoutmaster wants to go skinny dipping?
No.
see Scat. Let's go.
Okay, Sponge. You go.
Why me? You're the one with the AK-47. Okay, shoot for it. Get the paper beats rock, boy. Go.
Okay.
Go. Okay.
Go.
Okay.
What's up? What's up?
Keep it wired. He's not here. Get down, got him!
What's he pulling out of his trunk?
Shit! Looks like a body. Like one of those good old all-American NRA Ted Nugent type dudes. We thought you were like the 205 Tingler.
Oh, me?
Hey!
Whoa!
Face.
Wow.
Oh! Wow. These are great sausages. Space.
Thanks. The German recipe.
Hmm.
So. You guys actually thought I killed Johnny the Kid, huh?
Yeah.
He's the last person I'd actually kill. I loved him. I loved him like a brother or sister or a very special second cousin. He had that unique relationship with him in life. You know how it is.
Yeah, yeah. I had a cousin like that, too. But after Mom got us, no more slumber parties.
Sure.
So, if you didn't kill Johnny the Kid, I didn't kill Johnny Decay. Who the hell killed Johnny Decay?
Yeah. Why don't I show you?
He's hot, he's sexy, and now he's dead.
Taped this the other night. It's Johnny's first interview out of detox.
So, Johnny, how has your meteoric rise to fame changed your life?
You mean besides getting head in elevators from chicks I've never met? I mean, no way. I'm another freaked out individual, all right? So to all you inquiring minds, fuck off, all right?
Yeah, bitch, why don't you leave him alone? Okay, how has success changed you musically?
Well, I used to hate mainstream rock, and now I am mainstream rock. And that's why I'm making this new change. I'm going back to playing the music that people despise.
All right!
I guess it's as good a time as any to announce that I'm about to sign a 5-record deal with Urethra Records.
Urethra Records? Have you told Ronnie Orlando?
Yeah, I told him. He totally freaked.
You hear that? You hear that? He totally freaked.
Who owns all the rights to the existing Giant Decay album?
You mean?
Ronnie Orlando killed Johnny.
I knew it all along.
No, you didn't. Or else why would we be here? Do you have the recipe for this?
Sure.
Shit, I gotta go warn Angie.
Bye, guys. Mission.
Hi, Jeffy. Long time no see. Now, why don't we start with what you just told those punks?
I was hoping you'd stop by.
I need to know the truth. Did you?
No, of course not. God, you know me, I wouldn't hurt a fly.
Isn't that a line from Psycho? Look, Dirt, you know you're my friend, and I would do anything to help you. So long as it doesn't interfere with my career, my relationship with my parents, my car insurance, and my credit rating.
Anything else? Shit, look, I gotta go. Just listen to me, okay? Watch out for Orlando, he's involved. Just follow the money.
Dirt, wait!
Hello? Clive who? Oh, yeah, Clive. Yeah. Yeah, of course I'm grieving. Yeah, you must be too, considering you just lost Johnny before he could cut a single track. Oh, yeah. Yeah. Now he's hotter than ever. Yeah, my friend, death is definitely the ultimate career move. So what's on your mind, Clive? You want to buy all rights? For how much? Yeah, I'll get back to you.
Jesus, Dirt, open up.
Jesus, Dirt, do you mind knocking?
It's important.
It better be important. I'm in the middle of some critical research here.
Research, huh?
What the hell do you want, Dirt?
I need you to help me figure out an op.
What's the target?
Atomic Frog Records.
Hi, we're from Extreme Exterminators. Heard you had a major bug infestation.
Bugs? Ew. Are you sure? Let me just make sure that you...
Sector alert!
Do not panic! All right, I just hope this truth camera Zeke's really works.
Dirk?
Come on, let's go.
the hell are you?
Yeah, Chuck from maintenance. Yeah, Angie sent me.
Hey, all right! Time to celebrate my 32 million spaghettis! Whoa, right to my head. $500. 365 days. Yeah, I can afford it.
Right.
A hooker every day for the rest of my life. He's out. Come on.
Ronnie, tell me the truth. Did you kill Johnny Decay?
Billy made me do it.
Do what?
Touch his wee-wee in the bad place.
Oh, shit, man. He just did blow. A mixture of the uppers and downers could totally freak his system.
Oh, man.
Oh, sorry, Mommy. I didn't mean to make farts in the tub.
Damn it! Now listen to me, you're not 5 years old, you're a grown man. Now tell me, did you kill Johnny Decay?
No, I hired James Earl to...
So you had a murder?
I had to do something. James Earl, where is that meathead?
Oh, still needs a little more hot sauce there, James Earl.
What do you really think about me?
Oh, Dirt, I love you.
You hear that? She loves me.
If only you were more honest, more sensitive, more suave.
I am suave.
Richer, better in bed. If only you had a bigger...
Ha ha, okay, you don't want to hear that, bro. Trust me, let's go. Here we go, ha ha, here we go, come on.
To get into Johnny Decay's funeral, we disguised ourselves as the Masked Maniacs.
Masked Maniacs?
Yeah, we're the Masked Maniacs.
Open casket.
Open casket, what? Open bar.
Come on, man.
Yeah.
Thank you, and welcome to this very sad memorial where we are here to pay tribute to our dear, famous, and very rich friend, Atomic Frog recording artist, Johnny Decay. And now, Johnny's most intimate friend and a beautiful woman, a disturbingly unique talent in her own right, and the princess, a porn punk herself, ladies and gentlemen, Miss Holly Sumtightly. Come on.
Up yours and shut up. You think you love Johnny? You think you even knew him? You didn't know him. Not the real Johnny. He was mine. All mine! My knight in funky leather!
Nice room! Oh!
Fuck off, you dog!
Ball. Down,
bro.
Novo merchant.
What? Wait, didn't you hear him? It was Ronnie Orlando.
All right, like I'm really off my number one act.
Now, Sponge! Shit.
You're busted, punk. And that 100 grand reward is mine.
Johnny was thinking that I needed the money.
So you had a murder.
I had to do something. Oh, God, I don't feel so good.
What the hell?
See, he's the one who killed Johnny. Then he planted evidence to try and frame me.
Oh, my name is Tomo! Tomo! Tomo, I'm going both away!
Kurt, help me! No, help me!
And finally, I'd like to thank my faithful operatives and partners in Slime, without whom I could never have solved this case.
Now, I've been instructed to present you with this check, $100,000, courtesy of Ronnie Orlando and Atomic Frog Records. Lucky break, kid.
Yeah, no hard feelings, Harry.
Yeah.
Mr. Merchant!
I am so proud of you. Do you think we could ever go back to being...
friends? Sure, why not? But if you'll excuse me, I've got some work to take care of.
Mr. Merchant! I have one quick question.
Yeah, I know what you're all thinking. How could I take Holly over Angie?
Oh, my hero. He saved my career.
Well, the answer was simple. Payback.
So, Ange, what are we doing tonight?
Ah!
Oh! Ow! Ah! Oh! Oh! I'm okay. I'm fine.
Most people go through their whole lives blind to the things around them.
You ready to rock?
I mean the little things. Like the sound a woman makes when she's thinking. The smell of fear. The little mannerisms that give away when someone's lying.
Okay, close your eyes. Get ready for a big surprise.
Most people just aren't aware, but I am.
Shit! I knew it all along. But why, huh? Why?
Why do you think, Johnny, Eric, Bart, they didn't love me? All they wanted was sex!
You're a fucking porn star. What the hell do you expect?
A lot more! Like help with my career, some real respect, and maybe a half-decent orgasm once in a while.
What about Ronnie, huh?
Figure it out, Encyclopedia Brown!
All right, you two made a deal. You'd kill Johnny if he'd make you a star, and he thought I was the perfect patsy, but he was wrong. You were both wrong. Because if there's one thing I am, it's aware.
Oh, yeah? Well, get aware of this!
Ow! Bitch!
Alternative Investigative Services. Hang on one sec, let me transfer you to one of our operatives.
Yes, hello? Well, what seems to be the problem, dude? I think your bro is an alien. From which star system? Brother Zeke, better handle this one.
Hello.
Yo, Dirk. Bought a couple of new CDs.
Let me see.
Check it out.
Chainsaw Blues?
Spacey's ripping up the charts. There's only one album that's hotter.
Ugh, Holly, what a bitch.
Yeah. What a waste, though.
Funny, you know. I came to LA to find my dream. But it turns out, my dream found me. Okay, so it was a different dream, and it smacked me around a little, but it still came true. Now I'm my own boss, my own man with my own future. But I'm aware that there's one thing I still don't have.
Hey, Angie, how are you?
Hey, I need to hire a detective.
To do what?
Find a missing person.
And who might that be?
My ex-boyfriend.
And what is his name again?
Dirt, if he doesn't kiss me right now.
Wait, just so you're aware.
Of what?
That we're friends. Just friends.
Whatever.